Hey there, welcome to third video of JWE series from 100bytes.com. In this video, I'm going to explain a JWE. Before watching this video, please watch the first two video of this series where I have explained what is JWT and what is JSON Web Signature. So this video purely concentrated on the JSON Web Encryption, like where the mechanism used to encrypt a JSON Web token. Okay, let's spend few minutes for some theoretical part. So what is JSON Web Encryption? JSON Web Encryption is a specification provided by the IETF to how to encrypt the JSON Web token and send it over the wire. So this provides a cryptographic, basically this specification provides a cryptographic mechanism to encrypt and integrity protection of a JSON Web token over the wire. As we have seen that JSON Web token is three parts, like header, payload and signature in the last video. In this video, for the encryption we need the header and payload to be input for encrypting and encrypting with the JWE, which produces the encrypted content. Before proceeding, I'll explain what is JWE. JWE is also a specification which is provided by IETF, which is called JSON Web Algorithm, which provides a mechanism. Which explains the what are the algorithms we have to use for signing an encryption. I have provided the link for this specification in the 100bytes.com tutorial page. This is the way it gets sent over the wire. Basically, header dot encrypted content, where encrypted content is header plus payload. Basically, encrypted content has more than this, so I'll explain what are the things in the next slide. Okay, JWE token. These six parts form the JWE token. First is the header. The header will explain the metadata of the token. Encrypted key, the key which we use to encrypt the content of the JWE token. Initialization vector, as it is similar to cryptographic world, which provides a supporting mechanism to provide a strong encryption. AAD, which is additional authentication data, which is simply like a base64 encoded format of a header. Ciphertext and authentication tag are the output of the encrypted encryption process of our actual content, that is payload of a JWT. So these are the possible headers of the JWE token, which is almost similar to JWS token. In addition to that, two headers are added, like ENC and ZIP. So ZIP is like a it specifies the compression format. What is the difference between ALG and ENC? ALG specifies an algorithm which is to encrypt the symmetric key, which we use to encrypt the actual content of the data. Okay, ENC is like an which specifies an algorithm which is to encrypt the actual content of the data. Okay, this may be confusing now, which will get cleared in the coming slide. So as of now, you just remember ALG used to encrypt the symmetric key, and ENC is to encrypt the actual content. Okay, this is the actual token generation process. I have color coded each process in different color. First, we'll set the header. So setting the header for content encryption key algorithm and encryption algorithm. Here, content encryption key algorithm is which you will map to ALG of the header, and encryption algorithm which you will map to the ENC of the header. Okay, next process is generating the content encryption key. What is content encryption key? Each time whenever your token is just sent, a new key is generated, that is actually a symmetric key is generated, and it will get and that key is used to encrypt the actual payload. But we want the recipient side also to use the same key to decrypt the actual payload. So how it gets sent? So before sending, we have to encrypt the same content encryption key with the recipient public key. You see in the third step. So we are encrypting the content encryption key with recipient public key using RSA's OAEP algorithm. In this case, we are using this algorithm. So this is the head. This is the parameter. This value will be point to the ALG in the header. So when a token is sent to the recipient side, they will use this algorithm to decrypt the content encryption key using the recipient's private key. Okay. So after this encryption is done, we will encode that encryption key to base64 encoded format. And the next step is generating a RAND initialization vector. Okay. This is pretty straightforward. And the last step is last step is like an actual encryption will happen actually. Before that, we will generate the additional authenticated data. As I explained that, just simply a base64 URL format of a header. For the encryption, we will use the AES-GCM algorithm in this case, which will be which will be specified by ENC tag in the header. So now you may understand like ALG and ENC here, different between ALG and ENC. So using this algorithm, we will use the content encryption key as an encryption key, and initialization vector, we will encrypt the actual payload, that is like a content of the JWE, and which will produce the two things. One is like a ciphertext, another one is authentication tag. Okay, and these two parts are get encoded to base64 format. Now all these four steps are completed. As a final step, we need to concatenate all these five parts. Like first is header, next is encryption key and initialization vector, and finally ciphertext and authentication tag. All this get concatenated and send it over the wire. In the receiver end, they will use this token, but parse it and take the claim for the processing. Actually, this diagram clears the confusion if any about how the recipient key and the content encryption key is used. So here, like this is upper half is the sender side, where the header is first generated, and the content encryption key is encrypted using a recipient public key, and it produced the encrypted key and initialization vector. And here like actual encryption will happen for additional authentication data plus payload or claims will be encrypted using a content encryption key. Please note that we are not encrypting using encrypted key, we are using a content encryption key, actual symmetric key, and which produces ciphertext and authentication tag. So all these parts will be sent over the wire in base64 format. So in the wire it will be sent as a like a header and encrypted key. We are not sending an actual encryption key, I mean like a content encryption key, but we are sending as an encrypted key, which is encrypted using a recipient public key. Initialization vector, ciphertext and authentication tag, all those in a base64 format, and send it over the wire. In the receiver side, I just simplified the process. I want to show the how this encryption, content encryption key and recipient key is get used. So in the receiver side, first the receiver will decrypt the encrypted key using recipient private key, and they will get the content encryption key. So after that, the ciphertext will be decrypted using a content encryption key, which produces the claims. So this explains like how we are securely transferring the content encryption key over the wire, which is encrypted using a recipient key, and the content encryption key is used to encrypt the actual data. Hope this slide clears the confusion between the recipient key and the content encryption key. I'll show the program to generate the JW token that will clears more about this recipient key and the content encryption key. This is the Java program. I'm going to use it to explain how to generate the Java web encryption token. This program uses the JAWS library 0.4.1. This is a standalone program. Here sender and receivers are in the same class. Let's assume like after this is the sender's part. So after this line number 66, the token is sent over the wire and it is received when the receiver sent. Okay, so this first part of the code is to generate the claims. So if you want to know how to generate the claims, please see the first video of this series. And next is encryption part actually. So in the encryption part, the first line of the code is like generating the RSA key. Basically, this has to be in the recipient side, where the RSA key pair is generated and the recipient will send the public key to the sender actually. So assume like this is executed in the recipient side and the public key is sent to the sender side. And the next is like generating the symmetry key, where I'm using a AES algorithm and 256 bits to generate the symmetry key, which forms as the content encryption key. Now next is to generate the Java JSON web encryption object. So for that we'll call the constructor to create an object, and we will set the public key. So here the public key is a like a recipient's public key, and the algorithm value which we are setting is RSAOEP256, which will be represented by a tag ALG in the headers. So this this public key is used to encrypt the content encryption key using an algorithm RSAOEP256. And the next is we are setting the content encryption key. This key is and the algorithm which we are setting is like AES256GCM, and this content encryption key is used to encrypt the actual payload, that is claims, using algorithm AES256GCM. And this this value AES256GCM will be represented by a tag ENC in the headers. And the next is generating the initialization vector, and finally setting the payload, that is like a claims. After that, we are calling a compact serialization, actually encrypted, which will generate the encrypted JOT. So when you're going through this program, please compare it with the image which I shown earlier. So that will be very easy to understand by when you do comparison between that image and this program. So once it is generated, this encrypted JOT will be sent over the wire to the recipient side. In the receiver's end, first we need to build a consumer, like where we'll set the expected audience, expected issuer, subject is required or not. In this case, we are not sending any signature, so setting disabled required signature, and the decryption key is set to the recipient private key. So in the last slide, in the image, we have seen that content encryption key will be sent over the wire in encrypted format. It is called as an encrypted key. So in the recipient side, the encrypted key is decrypted using a recipient private key, so that you will get a content encryption key, and that content encryption key is used to decrypt the actual payload, where we'll get a claims. So this will build a consumer. Once the consumer is built, we will call the name method called process to client, where we'll pass the encrypted JOT. So that will return the received, that will return the claims which are sent over the wire. So let's run this program once. Run as Java application. Yeah, it ran. So here in the sender side, so you see audience, admins, expected, and all those things are sent over the wire, and subject, email, country, hobbies, and all are sent. Here, this is the encrypted form, which is in a base URL, base64 URL encoded format, encrypted JOT, which sent over the wire. And in the recipient send, so you see here in the recipient side that it's a success, that is a JWT validation is success, and the clients which is received from which we received is like audience, admins, and the expected issuer, subject, all the things are received perfectly. So that means our encrypted JOT is received perfectly in the receiver's end. I have uploaded this program to the 100bytes.com tutorial page, and I have provided the link below this video. You can use this program for testing purpose. So this is the way we have to generate the JSON web encryption token. In the next video, I will explain how to generate a JWT nested token. For more tutorials, please visit 100bytes.com. Thanks for watching.